In these and the next few videos, we're going to work with modes of convergence. As always, let me remind you that if you're finding these videos helpful, then you can donate on Ko-fi, become a member on Patreon, or buy t-shirts, hoodies, and more things in our store. Modes of convergence is something that we already know about. We know that if we have a sequence of functions, fn, then they can converge in a few different ways, like uniformly or pointwise, which we denote with a double arrow, or we say fn of x goes to f of x, but we say that it's pointwise convergent if it converges for every x. So immediately when we add a measure in our space, then we have this notion of almost everywhere. So something happens almost everywhere if it happens everywhere except on a set of measure zero. So that immediately gives us a generalization of pointwise convergence, because now we can talk about almost everywhere pointwise. And this will mean, well, it converges pointwise except on a set of measure zero. And we also introduced the spaces L1. And remember that L1 was defined with the norm, the L1 norm, and this norm was norm of f is just the integral of the modulus of f. And so this norm will also give us a new way of convergence, and that will be convergence in L1. And this is just the usual convergence in norm, that is, fn converges to f in L1 if the norm of fn minus f goes to 0. Or what is the same, if the integrals of fn go to the integrals of f. Now going back to these ones, we know that if we have a sequence that converges uniformly, then that sequence converges pointwise. And the converse was not true. There are sequences that converge pointwise, but not uniformly. Well, if it converges pointwise, then it converges for every x. And so in particular, it will converge almost everywhere. So pointwise convergence implies convergence almost everywhere. And of course, convergence almost everywhere will not imply convergence everywhere pointwise. So again, this will not be true. But what can we say about L1? Well, it's a bit more difficult to tell if, for example, uniform convergence will imply L1 convergence, or the converse, L1 convergence implies uniform. And that's difficult to say, but we will see now with a few examples that it doesn't happen. So the relation between all these type of conversions and L1 is disconnected, so none of them imply the other. And this happens for both uniform and pointwise. So let's work on a few examples that will show us this behavior. Let's take the family of functions fn of x, defined as 1 over n, and the characteristic function on 0, n. Let's draw a bit what these functions look like. So we start with f1. f1 is going to be 1 times the characteristic of 0, 1. So it's just gonna look like this. Then f2 is going to be 1 over 2, so 1 half. And then the characteristic on 0, 2. So it's gonna be like this. f3 is gonna be 1 third, so something like this. And the characteristic of 0, 3. So these functions are all going kind of uniformly to zero. It's very easy to see. So, of course, all these functions go uniformly to zero. And this implies in particular that pointwise, they also go to zero. So, pointwise. And we also know that pointwise implies that almost everywhere as well. But what happens with L1? Well, we will have to calculate the integral of fn. But these integrals are always have value 1, because I'm for the first one is 1 times 1, then for the second one is 1 half times 2, 1 third times 3, so these integrals are always 1 for every n. And so these functions are not converging in L1 to 0. In fact, they're actually converging to 1 in L1. So this example shows us that uniform conversions, or any of the others, do not imply L1 conversions. Now let's consider the sequence, the characteristic function, between n and n plus 1. So a little drawing again. So let's start now with 0. F0 is going to be the characteristic between 0 and 1, so like this. F1 is going to be the characteristic between 1 and 2. F2 from 2 to 3, and so on. These functions are just moving, and then, well, of course, for any other values, these functions are 0. So obviously this is not uniform. That's very easy to see, because if I take n very large, I'm not close to 0. I'm always at distance 1. So uniformly, these functions do not converge to 0. But pointwise, well, if I just fix one point x here, then I know that for n sufficiently large, then this sequence is going to have support something like this, and in 0 it's going to be value 0. So pointwise, it does converge. And so, because this is pointwise, this is also implying almost everywhere. And again, let's see what happens with the integrals. The integrals of these functions are always going to be 1, because I have 1 of height and always 1 of length. So again, these integrals have value 1, and so the sequence does not converge in L1 to 0. So we can see that pointwise conversions does not imply uniform. This is something that we knew, but it also does not imply L1. For the third example, let's take the sequence to be n times the characteristic of 0, 1 over n. In this case, the functions will look like this. The first function is going to be 1 and the characteristic between 0 and 1, so that's easy, just like this. Now the second one will have value 2 times the characteristic between 0 and a half. So if this is 1 half, the function is going to have value 2 here. Then the next one is going to go to 1 third, and it's going to have value 3 between 0 and 1 third. So these are getting smaller and taller. Again, we do not have uniform conversions, because, well, it's just easy to see from this. We can do a formal proof, but I'm just going to leave it to your intuition that convergence is clearly not uniform in this case. Now we can ask ourselves, well, do we have pointwise convergences? Well, if I fix some point x, then I know that eventually, for some function in the sequence, like in this case 3, the function has value 0 at x. So it seems like it is converging pointwise. But let's pay attention to this point here. If I take x to be 0, then my function is actually growing. So f of 0 is always fn of 0 is always n. So it's obviously not converging pointwise at 0. But if x is not 0, then f of x, fn of x, does converge pointwise to 0. So what this tells us is that fn does not go to 0 pointwise, but it does almost everywhere, because it does for any point except 0. And the singleton 0 is a point with Lefebvre measure 0. So fn of x does go to 0 almost everywhere. So this example shows that almost everywhere convergence does not imply pointwise convergence. Finally, let's see what happens with the integrals. And again, like all the times before, we have that these integrals have value 1, because we have 1 times 1, 2 times 1 half, 3 times 1 third, so these always have value 1. And so, fn again does not go to 0 on L1. So, almost everywhere convergence does not imply L1 convergence. Let's finish with a last example. Now we're going to consider a sequence of functions that's defined a bit weird. So we start with f1, but it's just going to be the characteristic of 0, 1. Then for f2, we just divide the interval into two parts, and we'll have first the characteristic on 0, 1 half, and then the characteristic of 1 half. Then for the next step, we divide each of these intervals into 1 half. And so we'll take f4 to be the characteristic on 0, 1 quarter. f5, the characteristic of 1 quarter, 1 half. f6, the characteristic between 1 half and 3/4, and finally f7, the characteristic between 3/4 and 1. So obviously this would then continue, so we would divide each of these intervals into two pieces again, and then define all the different values that we have there. But for this, for the drawing, this is more than enough. So f1 is easy, f1 is just the characteristic here. Now f2 is just this part at 1 half. f3 is 1 half 1, and it's obviously 0 here, at the same f2 was 0 in this other interval. f4 is from 0 to 1 quarter, and then 0 and the rest. F5 is 1 quarter, 1 half, and 0 on the rest, and so on. Then we'll have here, then this part, and then for the following iteration we'll have functions here, then here, there, there, and so on. So it's more than obvious that we do not have uniform conversions here. Now, what happens pointwise? If I fix a number x here, then because these functions are like recursively returning to these intervals, then there will be infinitely many n's for which the function has value 1 at x, and infinitely many for which the value has value 0. So again, we do not have pointwise conversions at 0, and we don't even have almost everywhere. But what happens with L1? Do we have L1 convergence? Well, if we pay attention to this, when I iterate, what I'm getting are functions that have this area. So there's zero everywhere except on this interval. And this interval is going to be of the form 2 to the minus k for some number k. And when I let k grow, when I let n grow, these rectangles are getting thinner and thinner. So the integrals of fn are going to be 2 to the minus k for some k that depends on n, but that grows when n grows. And so, in particular, this goes to 0 when n goes to infinity. Remember, k is actually some number that depends on n. And so, this shows us that we have actually convergence in L1. And so, convergence in L1 does not imply uniform, does not imply pointwise, and does not imply almost everywhere. So this shows us what I just mentioned here at the beginning, that we have these implications here, but L1 convergence is kind of separated. It does not imply any of the other ones, and any of these ones do not imply L1. But there is a lot more that we can say about convergence. For example, we can wonder what happens with subsequences. And also, introducing a measure gives us more ways of convergence other than almost everywhere. We will work on this on the next few videos.